making a box for a painting to be shipped. If you have a super large painting that you need to ship, U-Haul is a good place to go. This is a mirror box, 27 inches by 37 and 4 inches deep. So if you have a larger painting that's up to 36 inches long, this works really well from U-Haul. And I just will take a black marker and wipe, scratch out U-Haul and any UPC codes, and I use this for larger paintings. For things that are smaller, I've got an 18 by 24. I get a large box from Walmart. It's 18 by 18 by 24. They're usually square, so they're either 18 or 16 or 14 inches or something like that. But so I get the large one and I cut it down myself. So it is folded and it's about $2. It's under $2. So it's pre-glued and folded. And what I do is I get the corner where the seam is, and I use a razor knife. And just cut that seam apart. And I totally remove one of the sides. So you're going to make your box left with this three-sided piece of box. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you on the inside instead of the outside so that you don't have the writing to be confusing. My painting that I'm shipping is 18 by 24. So it's exactly the length of the box that is has already got its sides folded, and so you really need about 1.5 to 2 inches on either end for a bubble wrap and that kind of thing. So you really need it to be longer. So one end I will use to fold up for the sides, and I usually go with 4 inches deep. So right off the bat, I'm going to measure 4 inches from the fold. Along all the folds on this end. And just basically, I'll just draw a rough line just to connect the lines a little bit. So you have a kind of a guideline to cut with your razor knife. All you need to do on one end, and we're going to totally remove this part of it. It does not have to be perfectly straight either. I cut it at an angle there. I'm just cutting off the piece. One end is already folded up and ready to make the box, but the other end you're going to have to extend because you don't have enough length. The other thing you want to do is measure 4 inches up on one side from the fold. So I go up 4 inches from the fold. And mark it. This is going to be my new bend in my box. So I'm going to just very lightly score it. I'm not cutting through the cardboard. I am just very lightly scoring the cardboard. So I'm basically just cutting the surface, but I'm not going all the way through. That makes your cardboard bend. And so now you have the side of your, the one side of your box. It's ready to be folded. But I do want to totally separate it on the ends, because when you fold it, you're going to have to fold these corner pieces in to make the edges like that. Now, this box was only 18 inches wide. This canvas is 18 inches wide, so I actually need about 2 more inches with bubble wrap and everything. So I'm going to make me a new fold line. And what I'm going to do is come out just a few inches. And I'm not touching the canvas with the marker, I'm just making me a line. And I'm just eyeballing, I don't measure this specifically. This is going to be my new fold line, so I need to cut just very lightly, score. And then bend it there. That will be my new bottom. So I'm going to go ahead and cut all the way through on the end here. Just on the end, because that's what's going to fold up on the ends of the boxes. So that's the new bottom. That's the new bottom because I extended my piece by about 2 inches. That gives me enough space to use bubble wrap and everything around the canvas. So then I need to measure up 4 inches. 4 inches is just a good round number for a regular painting, pretty much even a gallery wrap painting. It gives you space to add a little cardboard and bubble wrap. Plenty of space for that. And then draw my line. And then very, very lightly score. So again, we're making another fold. Bend it nice and good. So now we've extended the box by about 1.5 inches or so, and now we have a new height for the box. Instead of a square, it is now a rectangle, and we're good on that. So now I'm going to turn it around this way. And because the painting is 18 inches, and if you have bubble wrap, you're going to be left with a really tight, you're not going to be able to get your painting in nice and with the bubble wrap and everything. So you need to give yourself probably about, let's say 1.5 inches. So just mark 1.5 inches. Yes, I did this on carpet because it would kill my knees otherwise. you draw your line. So you're reinventing this box into the size that you need it for $2, under $2. Plus your bubble wrap and tape, which might be another could be anywhere from bubble wrap and tape could be another $5 to $10. No, probably closer to 10. So this is going to be my new edge that I score. I'm not cutting, I'm just scoring it very lightly. So this becomes my new fold. And this right here is where the box is going to go up that way, so I need to separate it here. And this will be one of the corners. This so this will bend and then this will come down here, but as you can see your ends are too long to fold down, so you've got to cut this off. So from your score mark where your fold is, you come out another 4 inches. So I'm using 4 inches as kind of the go-to for the height, the depth of the box. It's only going to be 4 inches deep. That's how I pick 4 inches. So I just mark it. This part I am going to cut off because it's going to be where the box is folded up. And I know this looks like a puzzle, but it's actually really not. So now, when I fold my box, you've got your 4 inches that you just fold in, and you make it like you're gift wrapping a box, basically. So this becomes your new, this one I didn't fold in yet. This becomes your new box shape. So we have one end that we had to extend because the length of the box was 18 inches. I mean, it's 24 inches. The canvas is 24 inches. And we needed about an extra 2 inches in order to accommodate for bubble wrap and all that. So now it's ready to wrap up my painting once I get this ready. So I'm gonna move this aside. And for this, I start out with parchment paper. And parchment paper is what I use to wrap around anything that is painted, whether it has a varnish on it or any kind of painting. I use parchment paper because it will not stick to your painting. And for a painting this size, I'm gonna wrap parchment paper around it 2 times. shipping tape, which it's very hard to get anything to stick to parchment paper. So you just hope that it stays. And it will stay once you get your bubble wrap around it. Part here, I'm gonna just put an extra piece of tape. So now the surface is covered with parchment paper and nothing's gonna stick to it. I have shipped bubble wrap around it, and the bubble wrap will leave little circular impressions in your polyurethane or varnish. So I use parchment paper always. The next thing I do is I use two pieces of cardboard. So these are other boxes that I cut off that extra side to. And I need to make sure they're the length of my canvas, which is pretty much where the seams are. So I just cut right down the seam. So one will go on this side. One will go on this side. And what this does is it sandwiches the canvas in between just to give it some extra support. You could also use foam core board, which you could get two pieces of foam core board and just cut it down to the size of your canvas. Cardboard. The next step is bubble wrap. The end of that roll. Now I'm going to go, I went around that way, now I'm going to wrap it this way. open. You can fold in your sides. See, now it fits on the parameters that I refolded, and I still have some extra space to go on either side for extra protection. So this is bubble wrap that I've had that has been used before, and I just put the layer underneath. Still have space, so I'm good. So anytime I get packages, like with art supplies or anything that I order, I try to keep all the bubble wrap I can, especially for just extra fluff when you're shipping stuff. So I have a thank you note and an envelope and a bookmark with my website and everything on it. I'm putting that in there. So that's going to be in here with the painting. And that's a sunflower painting I actually did last year. And I sold it, but I made some prints from it. And it's I happen to have multiple prints, so I thought I'm gonna throw in a free print even. So I'm gonna put that in there as well. And that has a cardboard backing on it. So that it's nice and protected. Okay, so I'm gonna fold in the top and then the other side. So that's just kind of the first piece, just to kind of hold it in place. Then I'll take one and come across just to help anchor it. So I'll start with the pretty end that was already done. And so if you have a corner that's not cut, you just cut it to the edge so you can fold it in. So you fold that piece in. Fold in this corner. Fold that down. Well, let's fold this one in because it has the little side piece, the extra inch and a half or so that I had to add to the box. I'm gonna fold it in first just to get it in so it's nice and neat. And fold this over the top. And what I'll do is I'll do one piece of tape to just kind of kind of anchor it first. And then I will tape. I'll start on the end. Come across. This tape is thinner. It's not as good quality. I'll do another strip. Now I'm going to come across, down, over, and down again. Do that multiple times. Okay. So now the other end. Fold in the sides first, which, see, that one has torn, which is okay. That means I probably cut it too deep. And then I'll fold in the one that has the extra piece first. And this end. And now I'm going to do the same thing I did on the other end. Sometimes I put it between my legs. When you're working with just two hands. So basically, kind of go across both ways in both directions multiple times to make sure the corners are nice and snug. No chance of anything coming apart. Now I'm going to go back to the back side. And reinforce this multiple times. And then across. Checking all my corners, make sure everything's nice and taped up. I'm gonna go across here a few more times. this will be the top of the box. Making sure no UPC codes are exposed, because I would have to mark those out. So the last thing to do is just put the address label on. And what I do is I make sure it's totally covered with plastic. This package will be around $15 to ship from North Carolina to New Jersey, and I will have them stamp fragile on the box, but I'm not going to pay for a fragile shipping. It's an extra $10 or $15, but I will insure it for several hundred, and that costs a few extra dollars to insure it. It will go through the post office 2 days, and it's around $15. It's about a 4 or 5 pound box, and for this size box, it's around that price. So that's how I do my boxing. It's not pretty, but it does the job, and I don't have to pay UPS twice as much money to box it up for me, and I feel like it's very safe. So I've got two boxes that are ready to be shipped, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.